Hello everybody and welcome to follow the 2013 NASCAR Whelen Euro Series season review. The official NASCAR series in Europe has a new name after the signing of a long-term partnership between the organizers and Whelen Engineering. And we begin this one-hour review with the highlights of the opening round of the season in Nogaro. For the first start of the year, Villarino started from pole ahead of Zimmer and Gabillon. Behind, Garbarino pushes hard to break hard in the top 10, bypassing the number 17 Busena. Up front, the battle rages for second place. Zimmer in the number 64 comes under threat from Gabillon, and the Frenchman takes second place while Villarino opens up a gap each time round. Just outside the top 10, Silas Polisetti, the Indian driver in the number 18 car, is all over Stefan Sabates, and he takes the advantage over the French rival. Out comes the safety car, and the spectators are seeing the first restart in double file in Europe as in NASCAR. Once again, Villarino makes the best getaway, but this time Gabillon isn't at ease, and Iannetta attacks him on the outside, on board with Zimmer. And the two cars touch! It's all over for Gabillon, with a puncture. Nicola Rocca and Sébastien Doyer, the Scopus Racing teammates, battle for a place in the top 10. On the very last lap, Zimmer goes on the inside to snatch second place from Iannetta, number 28 RDV competition car. Villarino heads on to his first victory of the season in 7th career win, to the delight of the TFT Banco Santander team. Zimmer second wins the junior category, ahead of Iannetta, Nordström and Russo, the first challenger. Huge joy for Villarino, the reigning champion, and the champagne for the three guys will be on the podium. Villarino, Zimmer and Iannetta on the podium. Easter Monday and rain replaces the sun. Villarino again starts from pole position, but Gabillon is the fastest and takes the lead. Behind, Zimmer hits Nordström, and the Swede has to go through the gravel trap. Villarino is determined to get back in front and punts Gabillon onto the grass. Replay of the incident as the Spaniard gets a drive-through penalty for that. Spaniard dives into the pits. He rejoins in 6th position. But after a few laps, the reigning champion has closed the gap to the leaders. What a fight back, in 3rd. Gabillon and Nordström, Rapido Racing by Steel teammates, are back in the top 10. And they are running wheel to wheel, but Gabillon goes straight on the Ecole Alpine. Nordström gets past. Last lap, Zimmer is still in 1st place, but Villa dives down the inside to take the lead. And Villarino sees the opening and goes for it. He's back in front. A real NASCAR finish. Villarino scores his 2nd win of the weekend from Villa, who had to retire the previous day, and Jan Zimmer unbeaten in the junior category. Russo the first challenger, and Iannetta complete top 5 in the 2nd race. Villarino doesn't celebrate his win in usual joyful fashion. He knows he made a mistake and will apologize to Gabillon. In the championship, Villarino leads with 95 points, followed by Zimmer and Iannetta. After the pro drivers in elite, let's concentrate us on the open division with the young guns and gentlemen drivers battling for the victory. Aussie Josh Burden set pole position, followed by local lads Anthony Gandin. The number 18 Scopus Racing driver Burden makes the best start. On lap 5, Guppy overtakes Gono under braking on the aerodrome straight. Can Russo do the same? Yes, he can! The number 13 car passes in front of Gono. Meanwhile, Josh Burden leads comfortably from Gandon. And behind, Eric Kintal in number 2 and Italian Marco Rocca are fighting for positions. The Italian goes too wide on a wet curb and Kintal saw an opening but had the door closed on him. Both cars finishes in the gravel trap. Volpato, only 16-year-old, puts the pressure on the gentleman Joaquin Gabarón. He's really going for it and the drivers are side by side. A real NASCAR battle between the two guys. The number 64 car shoots past the Rapido Racing Bastille driver thanks to a perfectly timed braking manoeuvre at the hairpin. 20-year-old Josh Burden strolls on to an unchallenged win from Gandon and Goupy. Russo, who had a spin, to avoid a car sideways in front of him, and the last lap sees the flag in sixth position behind Gunnar and Baron. Burton is over the moon, winner of the first open race here in Nogaro. Local lad Gandon is overjoyed in the number 7 TFT Leclerc with his second place. Burton, the poleman for the second time in a row, makes a perfect start ahead of Rousseau. But in the first corner, Guppy tries to pass on the inside Gunnar, and the cars collide! And behind is panic. Christophe de Fiolant, number 46, goes sideways and hits Tierra Esteban in number 9. Restarting double file, and Burton pulls off the hull shot again. Behind, Gandon has problems with his heated windscreen. The Frenchman comes under pressure from Gaborone. But look at this! Gandon spins and manages to get it all back together. Philippine driver Enzo Pastor, who was caught up in the first lap melee, is making a storming comeback and passes Jerome Laurent under braking for the up-in. Burton has pulled out a lead over 6 seconds as he carves his way through the tailenders, and in particular his previous day's rival, Anthony Gandon. Last corner for the Australian, and he takes the checkered flag for the second time this weekend from Rousseau, who has managed to ride off Volpato. After a great fight back, Pastor finishes fourth ahead of Laurent, the first legend. In the championship, Burton's perfect score puts him in the lead with 96 points from Guillaume Rousseau and Julien Goupil. With the first elite race of the weekend, and on pole position is Ander Villarino, the reigning champion, in 1:22.96. The Spaniard takes the best getaway and leads the 21-car field. Gabion in the number 5 blue car is second, just in front of his teammate Nordström, and Ravavilla in the number 9 yellow car. The pack is heading to turn 3. And at the end of lap 1, the foursome led by Villarino and Gabion has already pulled out a few meters over the pursuers. A few laps later, Ravavilla in his Chevrolet SS start to push behind the Swede Fred Nordström, one of the 11 nationalities in the championship, but the Spaniard is nudged off the track, but he keeps his car under control. In the pack, Rousseau and Gandon are battling, while Roman Yaneta has a grandstand view of the action. The ADV competition driver gets past Gandon in number 7, while Bucena, the 2009 champion, is pushing like crazy. He attacks Grusso in his Ford Mustang, but he's pushed wide by Gandon in the last turn. On board camera in Yaneta's car, the ADV driver hits mechanical problems and it's curtains for him. After a safety car period, Villarino keeps the lead, but behind, Gabion and Zimmer clash and the latter spins. After 19 laps, Villarino takes the checkered flag from Gabion and Nordström, the first junior who piped the newcomer François Verbiest on the line. Confirmation of the results, Rousseau, the first challenger, rounds the top 5. A delighted Villarino celebrates his third win in 3 races. What a start of a season for the reigning champion. And Villarino is on pole again for the second elite race on the Dijon circuit this weekend. On the outside, Gabion tries to go around the championship leader, but it doesn't work. He goes too wide, and Villarino slips back in front. Before the end of the first lap, the order is Villarino, Gabbiadini, Nordström, Villa and Janetta, who is overtaken by Verbist in turn 5. The NASCAR Whelen Euro Series drivers don't give an inch, as proven by this late braking by Busena, who pushes Gando out of the track. In the Junior Trophy, Zimmer is on Nordström rear bumper and number 64 car hustles past into third place. So does Janetta on the inside at the end of the straight to take fourth place. On board with Villarino, the Spaniard scores his second win of the weekend, his fourth in the start of the year. Gabbiadini finishes second in front of Zimmer, Janetta and Nordström. Russo, the first challenger, is Nitz. In the championship, Villarino leads with 191 points from Zimmer, the first junior, and Nordström. Guillaume Russo, fourth, leads the challenger classification. On pole for this open category race is Anthony Gandon in front of Goupil, Russo and the championship leader, Josh Burden. Gandon is in front of Goupil, Russo and Burden, and at the start Goupil goes round Gandon on the outside, but they tag each other and Goupil's white number 44 car is slightly damaged, handicapping the young Frenchman throughout the race. Nicolas Godin, number 85, and Jerome Laurent, number 55, are locked in battle for victory in Gentleman and Legend trophies, respectively. The current leader, Goupil, makes a small mistake in turn 1. He goes wide and Gandon retakes the lead. Russo is third and Burden is still fourth. But the OC Josh Burden already gets past Russo and overtakes Goupil on the inside in the hairpin to take second place. The battle rages between Eric Kental, the current gentleman's leader, and the Legend Trophy contender Rezus Diez Villarroel in the green number 19. The Spaniard takes the advantage over the Frenchman in turn 1. Up front, Burden is all over Gandon, but the Australian is unable to find a way past as the Frenchman keeps hugging the inside line. Anthony Gandon holds off Josh Burden in the last laps and will score his first victory in the open category. Russo, Goupil, Verbist and Gono round out the top 6 as Kintal wins the Gentleman Trophy. Villarroel is the first legend. Gandon is over the moon. The TFT driver from Bayonne is congratulated by his mechanics and his rival, Josh Byrne. What a fair play between the two guys. Victory for Gandon on the top step of the podium. Gandon is on pole again after setting the fastest lap in race 1. And right away, Burden takes the lead from Gandon, who hails on the cautious side in the first corner. Behind, Verbist in his Toyota snatches third from Goupil. Guillaume Russo, who should have started from third on the grid, was unable to get away and will lose many points. At the end of lap 1, the order is Burden, Gandon, Verbist, Goupil and Gono. Goupil tries to take third from Verbist on the outside. Gono stays second, but behind Verbist and Goupil touch in the Sablier S's. In turn 3, the Frenchman goes too wide and loses two positions. Further back in the field, the Swiss are battling hard. Gabbiadini in the blue number 5 gets close to Vernet as they come onto the pit straight. Gabbiadini is very close on the braking and they collide! Vernet is lucky and gets away with it, but his race is over. In the last lap, Burden still leads, but is now followed by Verbist and Gabriele Volpato. It will be the first podium finish for the Italian youngster. Confirmation of the results. Burden scores his third victory in 4 races, consolidating his lead in the overall classification. Gandon and Goupil round the top 5, as Kintal is once again the best gentleman. In the championship, Burden now leads Goupil and Gandon. Gabbiadini leads the gentleman's classification and Laurent is in first place in the Legend Trophy. There are 2 categories in the NASCAR Whelen Euro Series, the Elite reserved for professional or semi-professional drivers and the Open for gentlemen and young chargers. The drivers share their car during the weekend and each races in his own championship. We try to divide up the drivers depending on their aim in the championship. So when we set the program of number 9 and number 18, we put Josh in the Open, in the 18, as we are going for the title, with a driver who's got a safe pair of hands and safe in Elite, to give him an undamaged car so we can stack the odds in Joss' favor, and that Sailesh, who's just begun in the championship, can learn the ropes step by step. In the number 28 RDB competition car, a Greek professional driver, Roman Yaneta, backs up Frank Violas, the gentleman driver. It's all new for me. I'm a self-taught driver. I've been racing for 6 years, but till now I've never had somebody who could show me what to do, so it's very interesting at that level. My job is teaching driving for a school, so from a pedagogical point of view, I know how to find the right words to help him understand things so that afterwards he can try them out. The racing club partners has made a different choice by entering two talented gentleman drivers. Christophe has 2 years driving experience, so he's still learning. I work like everybody else and it takes a lot of time. I'm not at a professional level, even though I won many races and championships in the past. She shares all her experience with me, and thanks to her, I'm making enormous progress.
Grâce à elle, je progresse énormément.
Here we are at Brands Hatch for the third round of the 2013 NASCAR Whelen Euro Series, the American Speedfest. Frédéric Gabillon is on pole in 48.390, followed by Ander Villarino. The Frenchman Gabillon keeps the lead in paddock hill bend from Villarino and Nordström. On board with Yaneta as he gets round 4 cars on the outside in grids to take 5th place. And at the end of lap one, it's still Gabillon, Villarino and Nordström in the first 3 places. Behind, Luke Wright has a big spin. He goes sideways after attacking his teammate, Italian Nicola Rocca. A big scare for Wright, who restart without losing too much time. Let's see what happened and admire the skills of the young Brit, who flicks his car around in the right direction. In the closing laps, Gabillon still leads Yaneta and Villarino. The top 3 are leaving the rest of the field behind. On board with Yaneta, who's trying to outbrake Gabillon, but it doesn't work for the Frenchman, whose axle locks up under braking and he punts the unlucky Gabillon sideways. Ander Villarino, the current championship leader, takes the lead. Behind, Gabillon is doing his utmost to make it back to the front. He shots past Zimmer under braking at Ritz. Last lap with Villarino on course for a 5th victory in 5 races this season. He wins ahead of the 2 rapid racing by steel drivers, Nordström, the first junior, and Gabillon. Yaneta has been hit with a 30-second penalty for nudging Gabillon. He finishes 17th. Guillaume Russo is the first challenger in 10th place. Villarino doesn't look that pleased, as he's congratulated by his team. Villarino is on pole for the second elite race in the American Speedfest. Gabillon is alongside him as Nordström comes under pressure from Villa in the famous paddock hill bend. All 22 cars get through without problems, a miracle in itself. Behind, Russo goes a bit wide and gets sideways and he crashes Willy Busena. It's a big blow for Russo, who injures his right wrist in the incident. Luke Wright in number 18 car tags Roman Yaneta and Zimmer takes the advantage of this to take 6th place. Anders Fjordback from Denmark in number 15 car is under threat from Anthony Gandon for 11th position. The Frenchman gets through on the inside in Dritz hairpin. The 2 Racing Club partners Toyota Camrys are locked in battle as Ravavilla laps them. The Spaniard gets cut out and hits number 20, driven by American Kevin O'Connell. Ever the opportunist, Zimmer can overtake Villa to take 4th place. Villarino increases his victory tally to 6th this season after another unchallenged run. He takes the flag in front of Gabillon and Nordström, the first junior. Jan Zimmer and Ravavilla round out the top 5. The first challenger, Bruno Cousin, is in 11th place. Pinarino celebrates his 6 straight victories, a record in NASCAR Touring Series.
Receives your applause, what a fantastic race victory.
In championship, Villarino now leads Jan Zimmer, first junior, by 44 points, with Fred Nordström by 45. Challenger Trophy leader Guillaume Russo is 7th overall. Let's get back to open category, and on pole is Josh Byrne with a lap in 45.083. He's followed by Anthony Ganton, Julien Goupy and Guillaume Russo. Byrne, championship leader, makes the best start, while Russo is nudged by Vincent Gono, and he spins! The Frenchman rejoins in last place. On the start, Byrne defends his position from Gandon while Russo on board begins to fight his way up through the field. He passes Jack Godin and Philippe Bodinier on the outside of turn one. He then slices past the Briton, Stuart Liddell. Gabarro, Volpato and Russo are battling for 7th. And the Italian will go wide and loses a place to Russo. The Australian Josh Byrne wins the first open race of the weekend from Anthony Gandon, who puts pressure on him throughout the race. Jerome Laurent, the first legend, is 7th, as Violas, the first gentleman, is 8th. And Apiosi is flanked by Gandon and Goupy on the podium. For the second open race of the British round, Josh Byrne is on pole again after setting the fast lap in first round. The Australian gets the drop on his rival and takes the lead from Gandon and Gono. Brit Iyengo, making his first championship appearance, is 7th. Once again, a big crowd is present to follow the spectacle of the young Chargers. The two legend trophy contenders, Werner in number 22 and Laurent, tag each other. After a safety car period, Burden makes the best restart, and Gando has to deploy all his skills to hold off Gono on the inside. And behind, Pastor in 5th, outbreak himself and hits Gono slightly. Burden is still in front, but Gando is getting closer and closer. The Frenchman is doing all he can to get past his driver and rival in the championship. What a battle in the NASCAR Whelen Euro Series. Will Burden keep the lead? It looks like Burden has problems with his car. The championship leader slows and has to retire with a technical failure. Huge disappointment for him and the Scopus Racing team. Russo grabs 7th spot. In the very last lap, Joaquin Gabarro odds off Gabriele Volpato and Kevin O'Connell to win the gentleman's trophy. Up front, Anthony Gandon heads on to his 2nd victory of the season. It's a good win for the TFT driver and he's reduced Burden's lead to 19 points in the classification. Local lad Ian Goff sees the flag in 4th place and is obviously very happy with his performance. Gandon celebrates in style, he explodes with joy and wins from the injured Russo and Julien Goupy, who was 12th on the grid. Gabarro still leads the gentleman's trophy while Laurent is in front in the legend trophy. Welcome to Tours in France for the 4th round of the 2013 NASCAR Whelen Euro Series. This major event is held, like in the USA, on an oval.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines!
On pole for the Michelin 100 is Gabillon in 13.985 ahead of Roca and Ellery. The Frenchman Gabillon will begin to pull away slightly as Ander Villarino, the championship leader, is stuck in traffic in 8th place. He's running side by side on the banking with his teammate Anthony Gandon. A great show for the thousands of spectators who came here to watch all the action. The leaders have to be careful in the traffic as they are among the tail-enders after a few laps. On one of the several restarts, Ellery tries to pass Zimmer on the inside and the two cars touch! Ellery loses control of his car and hits Ander Villarino, the unlucky victim of this incident. Gabillon led every lap so far. He's been very fast to learn the way to drive fast on an oval. He's in front of the experienced Max Papis, number 33, and the Swiss Jan Zimmer, who has some damage on the left-hand rear. He's under threat from Davide Amaduzzi, while number 20, Battenbrack gets another driver from the USA, passes Roman Yaneta for sixth place. Final corner for Gabion in front of Papis, and Amanuzzi overtakes Jan Zimmer on the banking in the last lap. Gabion scores his first win of the year from Italian Papis and Amanuzzi. Zimmer is the first junior, while Stefan Yagi wins the Challenger Trophy. Gabion from pole makes the best start, but under Villarino is on the inside line. He puts pressure and demotes Ellery, the 2011 champion, from second. The leading trio is followed by the female driver, Carole Perrin, in number 42. The inside line remains the best, and Ellery overtakes Villarino on the restart. The battle is still hot between the reigning champion and the former champion of the series. The leaders are back on the rear bumper of slower drivers. On a short track, traffic is a very important factor to build a victory on. Ellery, in the number 100 car, takes the outside line on the banking as Gabion chooses the inside to overtake Nicolas Godin one lap down. Ellery grabs the lead. Gabion won't lead every lap today. After 50 laps, Ellery and Gabion still lead. Villarino, Yaneta and Papis remains in the top five. With a well-set-up car, Gabion finally finds room to overtake Ellery and comes back into the lead. Behind, Bruno Cosa makes a perfect move on Max Papis on the inside line. He's no fifth. Bucena demoted Villarino from second place. Let's ride on board with the 2012 champion. And in the very last lap, Roman Yaneta tries to pass Villarino, and there is a contact! Villarino is definitely not in a good mood this weekend. He finally finishes 8th ahead of Yaneta. Second victory for Gabion, who wins from Bucena, the first in the Junior Trophy, and Swiss Jan Zimmer, who made its way through the field to come back from 7th to 3rd in the last two laps. What a gift for his 23rd birthday. Vincent Gono, 6th, is the first of the challenger. And after the tour meeting, Gabion moves up into second place in the standings. He's now 26 points behind the leader, Villarino, and leads Zimmer, the first junior, by only 5 points. Cousin Nance in the standing is the new leader of the Challenger Trophy. As you can see, the spectators have gone crazy and they were very pleased to meet drivers and teams. A chance to be very close to the cars as well. Anthony Ganton is on pole for the first open category race, the 900. He's followed by Josh Burden and Joaquin Gabron. For this 100 lap race with a flying start, the patience is the key. Burden tries to go around on the outside of the 9-degree banking, but it doesn't work. Several lines can be used on an oval. Oh, and Julian Goupy gets spun but gets away with it. He doesn't hit the concrete wall and can rejoin. On the restart, Anthony Ganton is on the inside line while Joaquin Gabron in the number 5 is passed by the other Australian Josh Burden and Vincent Gono from France. The Australian nudges his direct driver in the championship out of the way and takes the lead. A good move by the Scorpius Racing for their motorsport driver on Ganton in the number 7 TFT Leclerc. The battle continues between the two championship contenders, but Julian Goupy is no second, but he's nudged by Anthony Ganton and spins again. Only two laps to go in this race and Goupy is all over Burden. He shoots past the Australian on the inside line and heads on to an unexpected victory. The number 44 Chevrolet is now the new leader. It's Goupy's first win as he managed to find the right openings in the dying laps of the race. Anthony Ganton completes the top three. Gabron wins the German's trophy as Philippe Bodinier scores his first top 10 finish of the year and wins the Legend Trophy. An ecstatic Julian Goupy celebrates his victory in style. At the start of the La Calandrette, Gabron, the Pullman, moves over on Burden and the Australian is hit by Volpato. Luckily, the two drivers are able to continue. It was Joaquin Gabron's first career pole as Joseph Cosella keeps Philippe Stevny behind him in the banking in front of the many spectators who've turned up this weekend. Goupy, the previous day's winner, is pushing like crazy on this track and snatches second place behind his teammate Gabron. The French driver in number 44 slices past Gabron on lap 40 after a perfect pass. But a few laps later, Gabron is back in the lead from Volpato and Burden, and the 17-year-old driver gets past the leader on the banking. Great move for the Italian, who is in front for the first time this year. But on lap 75, the Australian pulls off a bump and run, nudges Volpato and takes the lead. It's the first time Burden is in front in this race. Burden rounds the last corner and the Scorpius Racing Forza motorsport driver will take the checkered flag to win the race from Gabriele Volpato and Renzo Calcinati. As you saw, everything can change rapidly on an oval. Joaquin Gabron, the third gentleman, finishes sixth ahead of Joseph Cosella, who scores his first top 10. Leonard Verne wins the Legend Trophy. Josh Burden is over the moon. The Australian opens up a gap in the overall classification. He now has a 26-point lead over Gandon and 36 in hand over Goupy. Gabron leads the Gentleman Trophy and Laurent is still in front in the Legend Trophy. Given the success of his races, NASCAR Whelen Euro Series decided to organize weekends entirely dedicated to the United States. Either the American Speedfest at Brands Hatch or the American Tour Festival, it's the official NASCAR series topping the bill. Behind the blue ribbon here is the cherry on the cake. The organizers have done a great job for the weekend. There is a lot of people. We could even imagine we are at the Le Mans 24 hours. It makes a big impression to see so many people. You know you're going to start with all these eyes focused on you, and that makes a big impact.
I mean, I've only seen crowds like this in the British touring cars, so in American Speedfest, it's amazing.
These major events attract thousands of fans, but also drivers who compete or have already competed in the United States.
We've raced in Mexico City, you know, Montreal, places in the United States. This is a great crowd. And I think the fans are going to love the aggressive, hard-nosed racing that NASCAR Road Course Racing brings. I mean, it doesn't get any wilder than these kind of races.
I think it's even better than in the Unibattle at the beach. It's like if we were in the nationwide race or...
It's as successful as what is done in the United States. It's great for everybody, the drivers, spectators and the teams. Since 2007, the American Tour Festival attracts every year thousands of people, and since 2012, it has hosted the oval round of the NASCAR Whelen Euro Series. The 600-meter circuit is unique in Europe as it's made for on-track action.
I mean, the secret to be fast on an oval here is that it's a very much of a team sport. You gotta be patient, but you gotta be aggressive when the door opens. You know, you can't think, and you just need to act on stuff. So that makes you understand, you know, how close the competition is and how important is the communication.
Can be. At home, it's all bank stuff, and then I like the flat tracks, and it's very different. One corner you're going really hard, and then the other corner you're going really, really easy and hard off.
On an oval, the spotter is very important. Is his driver's eyes and his advice help him to cope with what's happening? It's really important to have all this information with all the crashes and interruptions that occur. To be able to brake when necessary and not to go flat out, they have to be there to tell us what's happening. It's crucial on an oval with cars that touch one another. The spotter is part of the team and is vital when it comes to putting on a performance or not, as the case may be. The NASCAR Whelen Euro Series addresses not only fans of motorsport, it's also a meeting for the whole family. A unique concept in Europe will give spectators the opportunity to discover famous cars from the USA, like the sprint cars or those racing in the NASCAR Sprint Cup. To organize a meeting like this in so short time, it's a real success. There are a lot of activities for the spectators. We know that England is the country of the motor car, and we've seen that just how many fans have turned up. These kids have a big smile all over their faces. They're thrilled to bite. It really gives you a great feeling.
Yeah, it's interesting because, you know, this is my first interaction with European race fans, and they love cars. I think NASCAR is a great application for the whole, you know, car enthusiast type thing. But the fans have been super nice and it's been fantastic.
Welcome to Monza in Italy for the fifth round of the 2013 NASCAR Whelen Euro Series. This major event is held in the Temple of Speed and launches the playoffs, as in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series in the United States. an important meeting as points will be doubled. On par for this first elite race is Ander Villarino ahead of Frédéric Gabillon and the Swiss Jan Zimmer. Behind, the drivers do not hesitate to go four wide before the first chicane. And further back in the field, Marco Spinelli, one of the 10 Italian drivers competing, gets spun by number 85, Uxur. Behind, Nicola Rocca, Nathalie Maillet and Hugo Beck are the victims of this incident. The top three remains unchanged before the Ascari chicane, but on lap 4, Gabillon in blue number 5 car is decided to beat his Spanish opponent. He takes the inside line and takes the lead at the first chicane. Let's ride on board with Max Pappis, who drives for his own team this weekend. The Max Pappis Racing is currently fifth. On board with Villarino, who does a clean move at the end of the straight line. The Spaniard retakes first place and will pull away slightly. Frédéric Gabillon had to slow down a bit to reduce the temperature of his car. And after 15 laps, the number 2 Chevrolet TFT driver takes the checkered flag to win the race from Gabillon and Zimmer, the first junior. In the Challenger Trophy, Guillaume Russo wins and takes some points to Bruno Cousin. Villarino scores another victory this year. He celebrates in the arm of his wife. On the podium, the three championship contenders are reunited. Ander Villarino starts from pole position for the second elite race of the Autodromo di Monza. He leads Frédéric Gabillon and Jan Zimmer. And at the first chicane, Villarino goes wide! The Spaniard will be fair play and let Gabillon pass to avoid a penalty. Look at that! Jan Zimmer takes the slipstream of the number 2 car and takes second place at the outside of Curva Grande. After the opening lap, Gabillon has already a small advantage over Zimmer, whereas Villarino is overtaken by Iannetta. The Frenchman seems to be at ease in these tricky conditions. Gabillon, Zimmer, Iannetta and Villarino lead the field after four laps. And oh, the leader misses his breaking point before Ascari chicane. And he goes wide. He loses some speed and Zimmer and Iannetta take the most of it to overtake him before the Parabolica. Bad news for Gabillon, who gets passed by two cars. Zimmer leads in his first lap this weekend, but he does a mistake at the first chicane and Iannetta takes the lead. What a race. The order of the leading quartet changes every lap. In the penultimate lap, Iannetta goes wide in Lesmo 2 and loses the first place. The RDV competition driver had a clutch issue. After an outstanding race, the 23-year-old driver Jan Zimmer scores his first win in career ahead of Gabillon and Villarino. Russo thinks he's the first challenger. The Swiss is delighted and congratulated by Overdrive's team manager Philippe de Corsac and Jérôme Sarron. After Monza, Villarino is the championship leader with 533 points. Gabillon is 34 points back, just one ahead of Zimmer, the first junior. Bruno Cousin still leads the Challenger Trophy. The NASCAR Whelen Euro Series wrote a new page in its history as the championship went to Monza, the Temple of Speed. And on pole position for this first round of the playoffs, where the points are double, is Anthony Gandon. The TFT Leclerc driver leads Guillaume Russo in this first open division race of the weekend. Behind, Sabatès cuts the chicane and hits number 92. In the Legend Trophy, Jérôme Laurent is ahead of Leonard Vernet. The winner of this trophy will have the chance to do a NASCAR race in the United States. The stake is high. Meanwhile, Luciano Linossi, the wild card, is side by side with the current championship leader Josh Byrne before the first chicane. But the Scopus Racing driver slides a little bit and there's a contact between them. The Australian has to retire. It's his second DNF of 2013. Up front, Gandon is still first, but Russo is not so far away. The number 7 driver has led every lap since the start of the race and could take the championship lead from Burden. The TFT driver wins for the third time of the year. The young Frenchman is now first in the standings, 12 spots clear from his rival. He's delighted. Russo is second ahead of Luigi Moccia. Gabaron fourth, wins the Gentleman's Trophy, whereas Leonard Vernet scores another top 10 and wins the Legend Trophy. The Red Devil celebrates in style with his team. He's really thrilled by this win. On the podium, Gandon is more than happy. Anthony Gandon is once again on pole for the second open race in front of Guillaume Russo and Josh Burden, but Russo does a perfect start and leads ahead of Gandon and Burden, whereas Moccia and Quintal cut the chicane. On board with Byrne, who takes the slipstream behind Rousseau. He easily takes the advantage of the number 13 car, as does Gandon, who doesn't want to see the Australian pulling away. Rousseau is third, but it doesn't get early on the gas in the first chicane, and Guppy will take the most of it. He's now third. Burden leads, Gandon is second under the pressure of Julien Guppy. The Rapido Racing by Steel driver has not been very lucky since the start of the weekend. Gandon does a little mistake at the first chicane. Guppy is faster on the gas and takes second place behind Burden. Guppy is just behind the leader, but it won't be enough. The Australian scores his sixth win of the season and retakes the championship lead for 2 points against his main rival. Guppy finishes second ahead of Gandon and consolidates his third place in the standings. Leonard Vernet wins the Legend Trophy, so does Frank Violas in the Gentleman Trophy. Josh Burden, who had ups and downs this weekend, is congratulated by his team. The Australian is over the moon. So in the championship, Burden now has a 2-point lead over Gandon before the grand final at Le Mans. Cabron leads the Gentleman Trophy and Laurent is still in front in the Legend Trophy. Here we are, the last round of the 2013 NASCAR Whelen Euro Series season. The points will be, as in Monza, doubled. The three championship contenders, Villarino, Gabillon and Zimmer, are separated by only 35 points. On pole for this first elite race at Le Mans is Frédéric Gabillon ahead of the Swiss Jan Zimmer and the Swede Fredrik Nordström. Let's start on board with the current championship leader, Villarino, in sixth position. And Rousseau goes wide, and there's a contact for the Spaniard, who can lose everything from now. There's also a spin for Bruno Cousin, who aims to win the Challenger Trophy against Guillaume Rousseau. Villarino begins to recover from his spin. He's in 11th place before the end of the first lap. To keep a chance to win the championship, Villarino has to gain some places as Gabillon leads the race. In the Jérôme Sarron Junior Trophy, Willy Bucena has had a drive-through penalty after his move in the opening lap. The 2009 champion is now 10th. The battle for 7th is intense as Garbarino, second in the newly named Jérôme Sarron Junior Trophy, overtakes Fabrizio Ameta at Le Garage Vert. Zimmer, the first junior, is 3rd, ahead of Gianetta, and Villarino already 5th. On board with the Spaniard as Gianetta dives on the inside and overtakes Zimmer. Villarino does it as well. He's 4th after a spin in the first corner. What a performance for the reigning champion. His countryman Borja Garcia heads on to second place for his first outing in the NASCAR Whelen Euro Series. He will be a man to watch in the future. But up front, the Frenchman Frédéric Gabillon scored his third win this season and reduces the gap to 20 points on Villarino before the last race of 2013. Zimmer, the first junior, finishes 5th, but suddenly loses his last chance to win championship. Rousseau is 1st in the Challenger Trophy. Gabillon is congratulated by Joaquin Gabron in the pit lane. The suspense is high before the last elite race of the season. Under Villarino starts from pole position thanks to the best lap he did during the first heat. He leads Frédéric Gabillon and Roman Yanetta. Let's ride on board with the RDV competition driver. And Roman Yanetta goes wide to avoid Villarino. Guillaume Rousseau and Fred Nordström spin. Will everybody avoid them? And no! Davide Amadouzi, number 68, is the Frenchman, but Rousseau can go on to fight for the Challenger Trophy against Cousin. Gabillon has taken the lead, Borja Garcia is second, and Villarino took it easy at the start. He's 3rd and potentially 2013 champion. After a safety car period due to Didier Beck's crash, Gabillon has to take attention to Garcia and Villarino. On board with Jan Zimmer, who overtakes Anthony Garbarino at the restart. Cousin, who leads the Challenger Trophy, is under threat of the Swede Fred Nordström. The Frenchman locks his wheel, and there's a collision! Both cars spins! And Cousin loses a lot of time. He recovers just ahead of Rousseau, but the pole position 81 driver only scores 2 points more than his rival. It won't be sufficient to win the trophy. On board with Villarino, just behind Jan Zimmer. And there's another contact for the Spaniard. He's hit by Fabrizio Armetta, who had braked himself at the chicane. But at the same time, the number 46 Toyota driven by Natalie Maillet is pushed in the wall by Stefan Jagi. The female driver is unhurt, but her car is totally destroyed. The race is red flagged. Gabion wins his fourth win of the season after having led every lap. Roman Ianetta is second and Jan Zimmer third, as Borja Garcia took a 30-second penalty to have cut a chicane earlier in the race. Ander Villarino is the new 2013 champion by 4 points. For the second year in a row, the Spaniard is crowned. He's congratulated by the whole TFT team. With 7 wins, 8 pole positions and 8 podiums, Ander Villarino has perfectly controlled the championship. On the podium are Gabion, Ianetta and Zimmer, the winner of the Jerome Saron Junior Trophy. Rousseau finally wins the Challenger Trophy ahead of Cousin. Villarino with his kid before receiving his trophy from Jérôme Galpin and George Silberman, NASCAR vice president for Touring Series. Josh Byrne is on pole for this second round of the playoffs. The Scopus Racing Forza Motorsport driver is followed by Guillaume Rousseau and Fabrizio Armetta, the newcomer. On board with Gandon. And after the first chicane, Burden leads ahead of Rousseau and Armetta. Gandon is only fifth. Before the end of the opening lap, Burden leads Rousseau, Armetta, Gandon and Pastor. On lap two, there's a crash at the chicane! Vernet pushes back as Cosella tries to avoid the number 22 Ford Mustang and is hit by the Coppice Racing driver, Silas Polisetti. The safety car goes out so the marshal can clean the racetrack. On board with Anthony Gandon as the restart. Up front, Burden brakes hard on the inside line, but he stays second behind the Cal Racing driver, Armetta. Gandon is now third behind his championship rival. Every place counts for the title. The Legend Trophy contender Jérôme Laurent is just ahead of Gentleman's Christophe Dufialon as Jack Godin in number 85 Chevrolet leads the Legend Trophy here and will win for the second time this season. Up front, the battle continues. Armetta is the new leader for this first meeting in NASCAR Whelen Euro Series ahead of Burden Goupy, but Gandon is fourth and there's a contact with Goupy. Gandon has been surprised by a slowing down from the Frenchman. The 44 recovers after a perfect 360. And Burden is very close to Armetta, and the Australian does a perfect bump and run in the NASCAR style to take first place. Armetta gets passed by Gandon. Frank Violas is on the verge of winning the Gentleman Trophy for the second time this year at Le Mans. 7 wins of the season for Josh Burden, who has the advantage in the championship. Gandon is second ahead of Rousseau and Armetta. Goupy finishes fifth in front of Gono and Violas. Godin Nins is the first legend. Burden is happy, he celebrates his win, his seventh this year. He now leads the championship by 14 points before the last race of the season. On pole for this second open race of the Le Mans final is Anthony Gandon. The Frenchman is in front of Vincent Gonneau, who was very quick this weekend. Burden starts fourth. On board with Guillaume Rousseau at the start. Goupy is the leader at the Chemin au Bœuf chicane ahead of Gandon. Burden is only 6th, he would score 76 points, which is not sufficient to be crowned if Gandon wins. On lap 3, Rousseau goes in the inside, but he brakes too late and he hits Goupy! The Frenchman in number 44 car is very hungry and he will rejoin the track. But he hits Burden as he comes back to the track. That's terrible news for the Australian. Can the championship leader continue the race? He goes to the pits in order to change his puncture rear tire. Eric Kintal takes 10th place from Joseph Cosella. The TFT driver consolidates his second place in the Gentleman Trophy behind the Swiss Gaborone. In the Legend Trophy, Jérôme Laurent is ahead of Leonard Vernet. The pole position 81 driver is on the verge of winning a race in the United States. In the closing stages, Gano gets hit by Pastor, but rejoins in third place. A 30 seconds penalty finally will be given to the Philippine driver for this avoidable contact. After having led 16 laps out of 17, Gunner wins the race and clinches his first NASCAR title in the open division. What a finish for the season. Gunner is second ahead of Guppy, Armeta, Gabaron and Pastor. Burton finishes outside the top 10. Huge joy for the Red Devil from TFT. He celebrates in style. The Frenchman is congratulated by his team, as well as his teammate under Villarino. Anthony Gandon is crowned champion ahead of Josh Burton, who had been unlucky during these playoffs. Gabaron wins the Gentleman Trophy, whereas Laurent is the first legend. After the signing of a long-term partnership with Whelen Engineering, the four trophy winners are now heading to the United States to compete in the NASCAR race. Good luck for them, and see you next year for another exciting NASCAR Whelen Euro Series season. Bye-bye.